This headless professor video is about the scatterplot. This is often called a bivariate scatterplot because it is used when we have two variables, and it shows the relationship between those two variables. In this sense, it is a graphic representation of what a correlation formula is going to show us, the relationship between two variables. We can use scatter plots when both variables are in a scale that is interval or ratio, discrete or continuous. That's the broad range of what we can use the scatter plot for. Notice that the scatter plot has two axes, one for an x variable and one for a y variable. We put the x as the horizontal axis and the y as the vertical axis. If we have an independent variable, that's usually going to be x. And if we have a dependent variable, that's going to be y. If we're just using two dependent variables, x would be the predictor and y would be the criterion. Let's take a look at how this would work. Let's suppose we have five cases. Our first case is where the subject scores 2 on x and 30 on y. Okay, 2 on x, 30 on y. Let's put the black dot right there. Our next subject scores 3 on x and 40 on y. 3 on x, 40 on y, right there. Our third subject also scores 2 on x, 30 on y. So we're going to add another data point right here. Let's use a bigger dot this time. Our fourth subject is 1 on x, 0 on y. And our last subject is 1 on x, 10 on y. That'll be right there. Now, if we look at the shape of the data, they come close to approximating a line. That line is known as the regression line, and it approximates a formula. That formula is given as y equals a plus bx. Now, that particular formula showing the relationship between two variables has two components. The bx component tells us about the slope. In other words, this particular line, does it go up as we go from left to right, or does it go down? If we're going up from left to right, as we see here, that's a positive slope. And if we were to go down from left to right, that would be a negative slope. We call the point at which the line intersects with the y-axis, and here it would probably be a little bit below zero, the intercept. So we have slope and intercept. Now, I don't want you to get this confused with the Pearson correlation coefficient, which can also be positive or negative. Yes, when the regression line has a positive slope, as you see here, the correlation is positive. And when the regression line has a downward negative slope, the correlation coefficient is negative as well. But the value we give to the slope, whether it's slightly less than 1, which would be an angle less than 45 degrees, or whether it's greater than 1, an angle greater than 45 degrees, then that does not tell us anything about the strength of the correlation. The strength of the correlation is determined by how closely these points approximate a line here. They're pretty close to the line, although this one would be a little bit off. So it would be a strong correlation, but not a perfect one. The weaker the correlation, the more spread out these points are. Indeed, what a zero correlation would be is if we have the points spread out in such a way that there is really no line that indicates the shape of these particular points. That is what a zero correlation would look like. By the way, if we had an absolutely horizontal line, that would mean that the variable of y is a constant and we have no correlation between two variables. And if we had an absolutely vertical line, that would mean that variable x is a constant. And once again, we do not have two variables for a correlation. Now, this particular correlation, the Pearson correlation, also known by the letter R, is useful, but realize that the Pearson correlation is very vulnerable to askew. In other words, an extreme score on either x or y. And particularly if we have a small sample size, that one little outlier can really distort the shape of our regression line and our correlation coefficient. If you have an outlier, a better approach is to use a Spearman correlation, also known as the Spearman row. If you're looking for a statistical program to help you with Pearson coefficients, Spearman coefficients, or to construct a bivariate scatter plot, I'm going to suggest you go to the Staccato website, staccato.org, for a free statistical program that will do all of this.